while appearing before the Public Accounts Committee of Parliament to answer queries, as highlighted in the Auditor General's report for the financial year that ended 30th June 2021. Officials of the Directorate of Government Analytical Laboratory have been questioned on the high cost of DNA tests charged by the entity.
The people already paid for such a service, and therefore what government simply needs to do is to give people the service. Render it nearly free of charge.
I committed myself to pay for this DNA test because I am.
Oh, I saw where you said you already agreed.
I said I will pay. So it is good to hear, to know this, so that we can support up.
According to the director of the Directorate of Government Analytical Laboratory, Kefa Kuchana Kateo, a single DNA test costs 750,000 shillings in rates approved by the government. He explained that the charge is huge because each DNA test consists of three samples of a father, mother, and a contested child.
Oh, the cost of doing a DNA,
yes,
is 750 Ugandan thousand shillings. 750 per case.
However, MPs wondered why the laboratory charges similar rates for DNA testing like commercial laboratories, yet the government funds their budget fully on taxpayers' money.
The private laboratories charge 750,000 for DNA tests. I would ordinarily expect government
to be much cheaper.
Yes, like so 50. Why are you charging also 750? Is it because maybe these labs actually they don't have the machine and they bring the samples to you?
Legislators explained that the demand for DNA tests in the public is huge, but the cost of DNA testing is so limiting.
So I think it needs to be put in the members of parliament that actually you can get these services at this cost and this time, so that members start using the services. Once they do that, then they can be able to give information even to their constituents.
For example, Mbale, which covers my region, could be serving Western Kenya, and this would be part of the non-tax revenue that you would be collecting. The Gulu regional hub would be serving not just Northern Uganda, but even
South Sudan. And part of DRC.
So this would be, you know, an institution that would sustain itself.
Directorate of Government Analytical Laboratory officials explained that there was a spike of demand for DNA after COVID-19, which resulted in a huge backlog of cases. They explained that the high cost of DNA is another measure used to mitigate case backlog.
No, of course, during COVID and the post-COVID, we noted that there are higher incidents of sexual gender-based violence cases, what we call SGBVs.
Legislators faulted the laboratory for failure to construct the National DNA Data Bank.
In relation to construction, can we assume that already work has started?
Park also grilled the Directorate of Government Analytical Laboratory for underutilization of the digital forensic equipment, which is used to recover data on mobile phones that costed government 337 million shillings.
That an analysis of the use of the procured forensic tools revealed that Digal had used the forensic tool and equipment to process and analyze just one case. Listen to the word. Just one case in the period since its acquisition. It is probable that a proper needs analysis was not carried out prior to procuring that equipment, resulting in underutilization of the equipment.
They say only one case was analyzed by the equipment in the whole financial year in question. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.